Welcome back to Design Bundles YouTube channel. If you guys are new here, my name is Crystal. Today, I'm going to show you guys how to sublimate on white glitter. But I'm going to show you guys how to do this with Cricut. So we're going to do like a print and cut, if you will. So we can do our glitter cut out the exact same size that our sublimation design is. So they will marry up together because we don't want to put it on this big square of white glitter. We want it cut out, but we also want them to, you know, to match up. So let's go ahead and head on over to Cricut Design Space so I can show you how I did it. Now that we're over here in Cricut Design Space, we have a few things we need to do to get this ready for a print and cut. The very first thing you're going to notice over on the right, this is in multiple pieces. Your design may not be, but for me, all I simply have to do is come all the way down here to the bottom right. You're going to see a button here labeled flatten. This is what's going to turn this into a print and cut, and it's just going to flatten it into one layer. So now you guys are going to notice that we're getting a warning up here at the top. This is going to tell us that we can't cut bigger than 6.75 by 9.25. So we need to go back over here and adjust. So I'm just going to come up here and change this to 9.25. So that's going to give us 9.25 by 6.17. So the very next thing we need to do is add an offset layer. You can only do this from your desktop or laptop at this moment. You can't do this from your tablet. So the offset is going to allow us to add another layer behind this, which is going to be our glitter HTV. You're going to click offset, and you could make this as big or as little as you want to. So if you move to the left, this is going to give you a little bit of a skinnier offset, and if you move to the right, it's going to make it a little bit thicker. Now, one thing you're going to notice, all these little pieces showing it's going to cut all this out, but I don't want that. I want one smooth layer. Just click apply. You're going to notice it's going to change to all to black because we already have a black design. Change it back to white and you're going to see your design again. All right, so from here, you're going to see now we have this layer here. We need to change it from print and cut to a basic cut. So we're going to change that to a basic cut. It's going to change the color. No worries, just change it right back to white. And then from here, we want to come down to contour. So we want to get rid of all of these teensy tiny pieces. I don't want it to cut all of that out. Click on contour and just simply hit hide all contours. It's going to get rid of everything and just keep the big layer. So now you guys can see it's absolutely perfect. We have our print and cut, and then we have our glitter layer. Now, if you want to cut this out with your Cricut, you can definitely add a layer behind it and then flatten it as well. You're going to notice here in a minute, I'm going to hit attach, but definitely make sure you hit flatten. So what we're going to do is just move this back into place. We want to duplicate our glitter layer, if you will. So now we're going to have two of those white layers. And then we're just simply going to come to arrange, send it to the back. We're going to go to align and center everything back up. Now, one thing you're going to notice with this, if you decide to add another layer to it, we're going to go ahead and select both pieces first, just like this. I'm hitting command on my little keyboard here. And then we're going to click on, you want to hit flatten. I hit attach, but make sure you hit flatten. This is going to allow your Cricut just to cut around the border and not inside those pieces. But you're going to notice right away that we're getting that warning once again, and we need to size it down. So keep that in mind. If you add a border to this, your size of your design is going to come down a little bit because you're not going to see this border because I'm using a white t-shirt, but it's definitely going to bring that size down just a smidge. If you're okay with that, just go ahead, line everything back up because we want our glitter layer to be the exact same size. So we're going to go ahead at this point and change all three layers here to 9.25. So I've made sure I selected everything. So now we have our print and cut layer, and then we have our glitter layer. All right, so once you have these pieces here, all you simply have to do is hit make it. From here, we are ready to print it out. So we're going to go ahead and hit continue, and then you're going to hit send to printer. And then what you want to do, it doesn't matter what printer you're choosing at this point, unless you're sending it straight to your Epson. Turn off ad bleed and turn on use system dialog. This is what's very important. This is what's going to let us save it as a PDF. So we're going to go ahead and hit print, and then it's going to give us this option here. So we're going to click on PDF down here at the bottom and click save as PDF. From here, I'm going to go ahead and name this really quickly so it's easier to find. And then I'm going to save it to either your desktop, downloads, wherever it's easy for you. I'm going to save mine to my desktop. click save. Now, if you were using an Epson printer, for example, you could have just simply printed it out. I'm going to drag and drop it to my Sawgrass Smart folder, which is then going to open up my print manager. From here, I'm going to go ahead and change my substrate to the Siser White Glitter, change my layout to Preserve Layout from Designer. This is important to keep those settings correct if you're going to load it back into your Cricut and have it cut it out. So after this, we're just simply going to go ahead and turn off mirror because we already did that as well inside of Cricut Design Space. And then after that, we're just going to hit print and we're ready to go. All right, so now that we have our sublimation design, you guys could see how we were able to send this straight to our Sawgrass printer. If you guys were using an Epson, you could also do that as well. Now, I could have flattened this design, had a little bit of, you know, an offset, the same offset. I could have duplicated it and then flattened it so it cut around this with my Cricut, and then I would load it on my blue mat because it would be perfect for paper. But I'm just saving that step because you don't have to do that. You really just need to do it with your glitter so it's going to line up nicely. So we've already printed this out and we've also cut out our glitter. Both of these are mirrored. I'm going to go ahead and start by weeding our glitter design here. So what's really nice about this is instead of like using that big white chunky square or fussy cutting or anything like that, this is going to be absolutely perfect with this design. As you guys can see here, here is our glitter piece. And so what I'm going to be able to do is cut all the way around this and it's going to line right up on this one. So all I need to do is cut away my little square here. Just like so. And I'll be able to pretty much see right through this so I can line it right up. So it's not gonna be a big deal at all. But once again, I definitely could have duplicated this layer. I could have flattened it with one of those pieces and it would have cut all the way around that perfectly so it didn't get inside of our little pieces here. So you definitely wanna use flatten with that. And then it'd be easy, but you just need to cut it down to about this size. Now what's nice about this is it's going to allow us to be able to use 100% cotton. So this is a Bella Canvas 100% cotton and it's a darker color. So it's going to allow us to sublimate it, if you will. So we're gonna go ahead and start with smoothing everything out and removing any sort of moisture. So we're just gonna do this for around 5 seconds or so. Now today I've got mine set at 375 for 60 seconds. We're gonna start off with our glitter layer and we're just doing a tack down for around 5 seconds or so. So I'm just gonna make sure how far down that is. I think I'll bring it down just a little bit more. So I think this looks good, just making sure everything looks nice and straight. We're gonna go ahead and press this for just 2 seconds. So I'm just gonna go ahead and do this and press for 2 seconds. Looks good. You're just getting a nice tack down. Like I said, you just need around 2 seconds. It does not take no time at all to tack this down and you can peel it hot or warm. So now what we're gonna do, I let it cool down for just a second to make sure I'm not gonna accidentally, get any ghosting here. And so now what I'm gonna do is I'm just lining everything up. I can peek underneath, just making sure everybody looks like they're in their spot. I think this looks great. Once I'm happy with it, I can take some heat tape just to help hold this down to make sure I'm not going to get any ghosting. I'm going to go ahead and cover it with a parchment paper just to protect my press. And now we're going to press it for 375 for 60 seconds. All right, so once we're done with this, we're just going to go ahead and move this, remove our parchment paper, and then we're going to go ahead and peel our sublimation. And just like that, look at how cool this looks. We were able to sublimate, technically sublimate, on a darker garment and 100% cotton. It's just gonna give you another option to do that. There's several different types of HTV. I'll definitely be doing a video on that very soon to show you there is multiple types of HTV that you can actually achieve this with.
I'm gonna bring this up so you guys can really see that glitter and sparkle. So it's still very pliable depending on which brand you're using. This is Siser white glitter. There's two different ones, one that has more of a holographic and then one that's just more of a solid white. You can also do this on their sparkle, which has no texture. There's lots of different options, like I said. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you guys found it helpful. If you did, please hit the like button down below and subscribe, and I'll see you guys on the next one.